Hello, gardeners. It is once again I, Dick Juvie D. Durden, coming at you live with another devlog for Project Eden's Garden. You might notice, first and foremost, that I have a little bit different of a setup. That's because right now I am actually in New Jersey visiting my little brother. So this is his pad. This is his crib. But not here to talk about that. Here to talk about some pretty dang exciting updates coming for Project Eden's Garden. First and foremost, before we jump into the goods, I just want to thank all of you, everyone who's been part of the Eden's Garden community, all the gardeners out there, for all of your continued support as we've been working on the development of Chapter 1, your continued love, showing up to, if you weren't aware, we've been hosting some podcasts, pegcasts, I believe as we call them, in the Discord. Having a lot of fun with those. Great getting to interface with the community, talk to y'all, answer your questions. If you haven't been able to make it to them, definitely be sure to join our Discord. Check it out. I'm sure we'll be doing plenty more of those in the future. But without further ado, I don't want to ramble this entire time. I know we have exciting updates from several members of the team today, so I'm going to pass the mic and thank you all again for your continued support. Enjoy the devlog.
Greetings, everyone. Ladies, gentlemen, as well as anyone non or in between. I am Taco Mori, the director of Project Eden's Garden. This is the August 2023 devlog, and I'm happy to bring you guys some awesome news regarding Chapter 1. It's been around 8 months since the prologue's release, and we've been doing a lot of development work in the background, and I'm very happy to share what we've been doing. And so, for this portion of the video, it's mostly looking into what each department has done throughout the months, and yeah, let's dive right into it. There will be a new section in the devlog called the Game Design Update. Why is this a thing? It's because there will be new gameplay mechanics as well as systems in both daily life as well as the trial. I have mostly designed these mechanics myself, and they are inspired mostly from DR or just a standalone original mechanic. I'm looking for as many ways as possible to make the game as fun as it can be in every nook and cranny of Chapter 1, so please look forward to all those new things coming along. I'm also happy to announce that there is going to be two new class trial minigames. One of it being Rebuttal Showdown, and the other one will be its own thing. You will see in Chapter 1. I don't really want to spoil it, as I think it's better if I do not say it. Moving on to the 2D art section, we'll be looking at more updated sprites in the future. So after some re-review of our current sprites in the prologue, we actually see that there were improvements needed to the anatomy, shading, as well as the line art and posing of certain characters. So I'll just display some here on the screen. As you can see, we did some improvements on them. Please also look forward to new sprites in the future for the cast, as we have actually made quite a few for many of the characters. There will also be new UI upcoming for many of the minigames, as well as just other mechanics in general. Now, I'm aware that many of you actually ripped this game for its assets, so I hope the new sprites actually help you guys in the future. For the 3D art, I would actually like to announce a huge graphics update. So, back in the prologue, there was an ambient occlusion falloff problem. What this essentially means is that the shadows when the cameras are really close to any object are very, very dark. So the intensity is very high for the shadow, and most of the objects will look basically quite black at the edges. I'll show you some images in a bit, but we fixed it. So this is extremely huge, as this problem basically restricted what our prologue looked like. A lot of the models looked much more crustier than they actually supposed to look, and there'll be quite a handful of new rooms that will have really nice textures because of this. So, we can't wait for you to see what Chapter 1 looks like compared to the prologue. We're also looking to improve and polish some older models in the prologue when it goes into Chapter 1, so please look forward to going for that. As for the overall update on all the models, almost all 3D models have been modeled and they're ready to implement into the system. Many of the major 3D models have been already modeled, so that's great. We are also looking to create more modular assets in the process and looking into ways to make nicer textures without tanking too much on performance. As for the AO problem that happened, that actually ate up a lot of our GPU and performance. So we fixed the problem while actually maintaining how optimized the game is. That is great. For the programming department, we are looking to optimize the game further, as well as add new aforementioned mechanics. As far as we know it, the sprites as well as the UI take up the most space in the game. We are trying to find ways to sort of scale these sprites down whilst maintaining the quality of it and improve the game's performance overall. We are also aware of the feedback we have from the prologue, and we are looking to apply as many quality of life improvements as possible before we can release Chapter 1. This actually includes the screenshot feature that you'll see right now. I'll show it on the screen. You can take a little sneak peek as you can hide the UI and now screenshot the game. This was a very highly requested feature, so we will be including it in Chapter 1. As for the writing department, we actually have an application update. So, for those who aren't aware of this, around a month ago or so, we released a little poster saying that we do need writers on the team, and around August 5th, the applications closed. So we have received a lot of these applications, and we already have moved on to round 2 of the application process. So you don't have to worry about any emails or unread Discord messages. We already have them all in. We are going through all the shortlisted candidates at the moment, and I would like to express and emphasize on this one more time that none of these writers will influence Chapter 1, and Chapter 1 script writing is already completed. To give you a perspective of how large Chapter 1 will be compared to the prologue is already around 37k words, around under there. But Chapter 1 is already 100k words. It's already more than that. So, good luck to all you theorists out there. Before I end off this part of the video, I would like to address certain roadblocks that the team had along the way here. First of all, normally I would not like to bring a personal part of my life into this devlog, as this is about the development of Eden's Garden, not really about my personal life. However, I had an accident in July that kind of caused a marginal amount of my energy to be taken away from the project temporarily. Around the months of July to August, that's when I had an accident that involved a broken bone that I was not aware of. Now, from the release date of this devlog, around a few weeks ago, I had this surgery, and currently I am in the midst of recovering from just post-surgery in general. This surgery does take around 1 month to around 1 year to heal. This, however, does not mean that I will take my eyes off this project. However, I'm saying this because it has taken around a month of my time to kind of like look away from this project. And I would like to express that this might have affected the deadline of the project. So I do wish to ask for your understanding if there was a delay eventually in the future. I can't really sort of foresee confidently right now when the project would be released. If I were to give it a guess, it would be around late 2023 to 24, around like early 2024. However, this is one of the major roadblocks we had on the way. There were also other roadblocks that I would like to address, such as that there were some assets that were lost in a hard drive that kind of exploded when one of the 3D modelers was doing their work. So we're currently kind of picking up the pieces together of these lost assets and rebuilding it. We're actually doing a pretty good job on doing that, so that's great. However, I didn't really want to end this part on a bad note, but I thought that the community needs to know about this. And thank you for all your understanding on our development. Before I head off to the Q&A, I would also like to address that there is one surprise waiting for you at the end of this video. And I would like everyone who's excited about Chapter 1 to see it. It is a big surprise that me and Panic have prepared for all of you, so we hope that you will like it. Thank you.
Hey guys, just a quick announcement regarding the sound department. I'm very happy to announce that we'll be working with guest stars Nicole and Scotty to bring you a lyrical track for the Chapter 1 credits. Nicole and Scotty are a musical duo. You can find all their socials in the description, so go show them lots of love. This will be the first of hopefully several collaborations with different artists, so we're very excited for that and very thankful that Nicole and Scotty were willing to be on the project. We'll be releasing this track on the Chapter 1 album as well as a standalone single, and if you stick around to the end of the video, you might even get to hear a tiny sneak peek of it. That's all I've got for now. Please enjoy the rest of the devlog.
For this section, I would like to talk about the most frequently asked questions from the community, starting from the first one. When is Chapter 1's release? We are aiming to get it done by 2023, but there is a possibility it might be bleep past it. We don't feel comfortable confirming a release date just yet, as one of the biggest contributing factors of affecting this release date would be playtesting. Due to the large amount of new mechanics in Chapter 1 and the size of the chapter, we might need more time to playtest and polish the game compared to the prologue. So an estimate would be around late 2023 to early 2024. Whenever we gauge a release, we do it when we are in late development, So around, I would say, more than 70% of the way. We would also include life circumstances or possible roadblocks in a way. Currently, I would say we are around 50% along the way, give or take. The first 50% right now that we have completed, or more so mostly completed, would be the writing, the programming backend, as well as the 3D asset development. So I would say that we are somewhat on track with that. Were there any issues with optimization in terms of 3D assets or gameplay system implementations? From Sweden, he said, honestly, everything basically. I would just like to elaborate on this, but for 3D assets, we do our best to keep our polygon count low so Unity doesn't combust itself. The one that takes the most space is actually the UI as well as 2D assets. So we are finding ways, like I said earlier, to kind of scale down everything to keep the file size low. What was your motivation for story writing? What motivated you to write the plot for the Fangen? So, the motivation came from wanting to create our own take of DR writing and its own mechanics, kind of like our own standalone take. Our story is very much inspired by DR, by how the story is written, how Kodaka writes a story. My main motivation is to improve the already introduced concepts in Danganronpa and even introduce more concepts into our writing. Our universe is not at all connected to DR's canon. So we want to provide a unique experience to all of you whilst taking inspiration from DR. We want all of you to break away your expectations of DR and kind of go into this game fresh. I know you said in a Q&A with Weeby News that you wanted to add your own minigames. Are you allowed to talk more on that? Also, will you be re-adding some of the minigames from the original? Example being Debate Scrum, Mass Panic Debate, and the lie mechanic. For the minigames, I assume you meant trial. And yes, in chapter 1, there will be two new trial minigames that exist that I previously mentioned. We only have a limited amount of minigames that will be added to this game, as adding more will be a huge time sink and it will expand our already large scope. For future releases, I can see perhaps at max 2 or more minigames added. However, that's only if we have time and that's feasible. As you plan to release future chapters periodically, how do you plan to deploy later releases? Will each chapter be a separate executable, or will there be a way to update our versions of the game that will work with the previous save states? So, to answer that, we will actually update the itch.io as well as the game jolt. Save files from the first game, the prologue, will actually carry over to the updated version automatically. So you won't really have to worry about losing any save files. Will there be a demo of a minigame from the first chapter like there was for chapter 0? At the moment, I don't see it happening right now. However, if this changes, there will be a server-wide announcement as well as a Twitter announcement. When working on the first game, what came first? Programming, gameplay, or writing? For me personally, I would say please do write first. Concepting should always be first with your design. This will help your programmers and every single member on your team to work very well. Not a hugely important question, but will the trial room change designs depending on the chapter? Well, if it does, it won't be by a huge margin, but this is more on the polishing side of things, so I would say a 50-50 chance at the moment. Would there be new music made for chapter 1? Yes! Expect new tracks to actually drop soon. What have been some of your favorite fan creations slash memes slash fan reactions? Is there any specific part of the prologue that you love seeing people react to? To start with the fan creations, I would like to talk about the art. I don't think I can really choose a favorite because literally every piece of art for the game has me in shambles. Like seeing the skill and talent that comes from all of you, the audience, has personally astounded me even to this day. For some other fan content, I would actually like to point to YouTube, where I am gonna just shout out Weeby News, Nezumi VA, Blaze, and even Bijou Mike. Shout out to all these creators for helping us with the content. I love watching your gameplay videos, and we make it an effort to share it to all our family and friends all the time. Not just these creators, every reaction or content creator, even small creators, we always try to like it and even watch through it every time we see it on our feed. And I would like to actually give some small creators shout out. There is a personal video I really like from Tofu De Maru. They basically analyzed the prologue in a very nutshell version and it made me laugh throughout. So here's like a video thumbnail for you here. And there is a recent video that caught my attention. It is by the Humbugs. It's a recent video called Project Eden's Garden and Analysis. they dive really deep into what happens in the prologue and what they theorize about each character, and I found the video very interesting. As for the memes, we have many running jokes on our team and people who regular our server. So, I remember that in one of our videos, there was a comment that basically lambasted every character of the cast with one sentence per character. However, when it came to Cassidy, that was an entire essay psychoanalyzing a character top down. I found it so funny that I could not stop sharing it with everyone because there were a lot of words used in that paragraph that just was so shocking and hilarious. So it kind of became a copypasta in our team as well as just in general the Discord server. Speaking of the Discord server, there's an entire manifesto that spans 34 pages long about a Winona Council and what it takes to be part of the Winona Council. We also have a cult of Toshiko fans called the TKA. I think it just means Toshiko Kaiora Association. So there is a literal cult for each character. Like, there's literal cults for each character of the cast. And I find that hilarious and absolutely appalling. Please keep doing everything you do, guys. So, yeah, overall, those are my favorite things that have come out from this project, and I just thought to mention it. And just a last little lighthearted question that I want to throw in, personally. How do you feel about the fact that the abbreviation of Project Eden's Garden is just PEG, but saved by the colon? Well, I think it's very unfortunate. But I guess it makes it more memorable, right? And that's it for the Q&A. So, thank you guys for asking all these questions. If you guys have any more questions, please do forward it to the Eden's Garden Questions channel in the Discord server. Thank you.
Hey everyone, it's everybody's favorite PR guy, Shade here. I'm very excited to talk to you guys in the devlog for the very first time. For those who don't know me, you might have seen me moderating FAQ sessions, planning server events, or even we've generally interacted in general at VC before. But I'm Shade, the technical producer behind Project Eden's Garden, and I'm mainly managing the marketing and PR relevant stuff, as well as some community events here and there. Today, I'm going to talk to you guys about some upcoming community news, as well as some updates towards our localization progress and general news updates for Project Eden's Garden. So let's start off with our current localization progress. The last time we talked to you guys about it was the announcement of our 7 languages, which are going to be fully translated for our prologue section for Project Eden's Garden. And as of today, I'm proud to announce that we're going to be adding one more language to our roster, which is Japanese. A lot of people have requested it, and I'm very excited to start translating that as well with our team. And while we hope to release every languages at the same time, please note that our progress for each language can take some time more respectively. So if we do inevitably release one, it probably takes some while for the other ones. It's mainly the reason that we have to kind of like rely on our availability of anyone who's available during that time to translate, so the progress may vary here and there. Which on that note, I would also like give you a brief overview on how we handled the translation process. As you can see from our progress here, each language is divided into 3 main stages for the progress. So the first stage is mainly consisting of generally translating the entire game, where we provided them the script and they make sure that every line is properly translated. The second stage is more of a proofreading process where the leads are kind of like checking out if the lines are being delivered properly and nothing is lost in terms of translations. And then the last stage is probably the most complex one, is making sure that all UI assets or assets that are basically visual assets are properly translated as well, using localization editors that we have to make sure that every time we using a specific counter or like a consent that's being visualized in the game, this is properly translated as well. The development team was very kind enough to share the corresponding project files to accurately follow the same style of the game. So the only minor changes that you might see are some very minor font changes, especially for Russian and Japanese versions of the game. But other than that, it should basically remain the same. And yeah, we were really inspired by the works of Alex CM's team, who basically followed up with this kind of process, and we want to do a same fully immersive experience to you guys as well in your language to play. One more thing to note on that is that we're currently reopening polls for anyone who's interested in joining localization teams, mainly translators for the languages German, Castilian, Spanish, and Japanese, as well as some localization editors who can help us editing the graphics into their corresponding languages. We are mainly looking for these kinds of people, as we are lacking in terms of like progress in there. So if you have a spare time and looking for something to translate, this would be the opportunity to do so, and we would be very happy to have you guys in our team. One more thing to note about the localization editors is that there is no real requirement to know the actual language of it, as long as you know how to edit these specific graphic assets and make sure that the art style is similar to that, we would be more than happy to let you join us and helping out wherever you can. You can apply by using the application link, which is linked in the description below of the video. And if you have any more questions on that note, please let me know by just DMing me on Discord or on the other social medias that we have provided below as well. Now let's talk about our upcoming community events. We currently have three planned, of which two are already announced. The first of which is the currently ongoing weekly podcast event that we're doing here, where we talk behind the scenes about how we developed Project Eden's Garden from the ground up to the release of the prologue chapter of the game. The event will be hosted by yours truly, and alongside with our moderation team, we're invite fellow team members to talk about some unique insights on how the process was done and how the game was generally developed. So if you're interested in such a topic and would like to catch us live by asking a specific question, feel free to join our Discord server for more information on that matter, and hope to see you there live as well. We will also, for those who won't unfortunately make it or have missed these podcast events, don't worry, we'll be also uploading these episodes in our YouTube channel after editing them, and we'll be announcing them separately in our Discord server. Just give us a bit more time in that aspect, since we want to make sure that everything looks fine and has the same quality as our other videos. Following up, we will also be hosting our next summer-themed server event, which is our Project Eden's Garden summer-themed character fanart contest. We noticed you guys have been loving our characters cast so far, and thought that would be like a right opportunity to see you guys drawing your favorite character in a summer outfit, and hopefully we're not too late to still host these kind of like things, but we wanted to see you guys your passion and want to give you guys something back on that matter. The winners will be exclusively featured in our upcoming announcements, as well as receive special Discord roles, social media shoutouts, and perhaps one or two things more. For more info, we'll be announcing that in our Discord server as well. So in regards to that, we will be following up on this fan art contest as well. Just make sure to keep an eye out in our socials, and you'll see how along the events will kind of like start and end on that matter. And yeah, that's it from me. Before I go, I would like to personally thank you guys for your ongoing support. It's been a blast developing this game for the past 2 years, and seeing your guys' reaction of like when we do inevitable release stuff like that. So it's been a pleasure of working with you guys, and hopefully I can see you until the very end when we release our last chapter. Until that, next up we have Anthony, who will be talking about the San Japan Expo event, and I will be seeing you guys on perhaps the next episode. Bye!
Well, Before we get to that, there we go. Good evening, everyone. Now, this is the first time you guys have seen my face on the YouTube channel. And if you do not know me, I am one of the video editors for Project Eden's Garden. My name is Stephen Long. I usually make the devlogs and the music videos. My specialty is the puppeting and illustration animation of usually the music videos that you guys may have seen. Our other video editor is Andrew. He is the one who made the announcement trailer and the prologue trailer, pretty much the very official things for Project Eden's Garden. Not many people, but there are some people who do ask me, how do I make these devlog videos? You know, given this chance, I can actually show you how my process works. So allow me to give you a little brief insight of how that works. Oh my God. What the f-? So why am I actually here? Well, Taco, the beloved director of Project Eden's Garden, has given me permission to announce a small fan project of mine regarding Project Eden's Garden. So it's a fan project of a fan project. This small project that I am working on is called Fan Art Tribute Video. Now, I have actually made another fan art tribute video, probably I think it was 2 years ago, on the Discord server. So if you have been on the Discord server for a long time, you probably have seen it. And, you know, in retrospect, it is actually pretty good, but I know that I can do better. I know that I can make something that's truly outstanding, especially since I have learned so much in video editing and puppet animation. So what is the fan art tribute video? Well, as the name entails, it's just me making a massive video that entails a bunch of your guys' fan arts. This is usually in the sense of like a music video kind of thing, where I just take a song that I like and I just make it into a music video that shows these fan arts all across the screen in the beat of the music, right? There is a reason why I am announcing this on the YouTube channel, and that's because I am going to need your help. See, I made the first fan art tribute video before Chapter Zero was released. And now that I'm making the second tribute video after the release of Chapter Zero, the Discord server has surged, absolutely surged in members. And it's honestly really hard to keep track of all of the fan arts that you guys make. What am I needing your help on? I have a link down in the description, which I would like you guys to watch the rest of this devlog before going to that link. This is just me getting my stuff out of the way so that you guys can enjoy the content afterwards. So there is a link down in the description. It is a forms document where you can submit your own fan art directly to me so that I can actually see everything, so that I can have all of your usernames in conjunction with your fan art so I don't get confused. So hopefully I can deliver on this to you guys, because I have been thinking about this project for months now. I've been imagining what I can do, the different techniques, the scenery that I can do, just a lot of ideas that I have in my head. Maybe it's too much, don't know yet, but honestly, we'll get there when I get there. This video is going to take a lot of time, especially because video editing is not my full-time job. It is just a hobby of mine. But I also can't guarantee that your art is also going to be in this video. If there is going to be a lot of fan art submitted, there is a chance that your fan art just did not fit anywhere. I do also want to mention that I am not going to animate every single one of your guys' art. That's just going to take much, much longer than it should be. But I don't want to take any more of your time up, so whoever is speaking after me, give them a big old welcome. I hope to see you guys in a nearby future, and it was nice seeing you guys for the first time, or you guys seeing me for the first time. It's the first time I actually ever been on camera, so this is wild. Anyways, bye-bye.
Hello ladies and gentlemen and everyone in between, my name is Anthony, I'm one of the 3D modelers for Project Eden's Garden. You may also know me as the voiceover for our installation tutorial back in December. I'm here to present to you more details about our presence at San Japan this year. So San Japan is a massive anime and gaming convention taking place Labor Day weekend, September 1st through the 3rd in San Antonio, Texas. We are hosting an indie gaming booth featuring Chapter 0, Vows Woven by Stitches and Needles, and Chapter 1. This will be the early parts of Chapter 1, but it should satisfy you until our full release in the coming months. We're also going to be giving out some free little goodies and go-dooders. One of them is going to be a sticker sheet drawn by our Cassidy VA, Sabrina. Look how cool they look. Wow. Our second gift is our second little goodie. Is a giant poster of the key art for Chapter 0. It's got some different text too, so it's a unique, it's not just the same exact thing. Did some slight color grading adjustments. It's very nice, it's very cool. I accidentally tore my corner while trying to get it off my wall to showcase it, but I really like it. It's really high quality, it's very nice, it's paper. Wow. But don't just take my word for it. Look how much other people are enjoying theirs. Don't eat the poster. Stop eating the poster. Stop. We're also going to be hosting a panel featuring some of the development team with more in-depth behind the scenes about Chapter 0 and Chapter 1. Your hosts will be Dick Juve Durden, our lead technical director, Benjamin Sweden-Gilson, our lead programmer, Hayden Graves, our lead composer, Robbie Good, our other composer, Hannah Majors, the voice actor behind Eloise Tallner, the ultimate fencer, Dakota Farnsworth, the voice actor behind Kai Montiago, the ultimate influencer, and me. Wow. This panel will hopefully be live streamed for those who cannot attend San Japan. More details on time and place of said events will have to wait a while. In fact, if you join our Discord server tonight at 8 p.m. EST, we should be able to give you more details on scheduling, because we don't have the schedules yet, but by the time this airs, we will. It is currently the 20th of August, 2023, at 10 in the morning. Yippee. And we hope you look forward to the release of Chapter 1 in the coming months, and even further beyond. Go to San Japan, if you can. Alright, so special shout out to Dakota's mom. They're pretty sick. They supplied the posters for us. They're freaking awesome. I've never met the lady. I bet she's wonderful. Do some hearts, Dakota's mom's in the chat. All right, don't be weird about it, but just do that live chat, premiere chat. I see you. Comment section. Make sure to post heart Dakota's mom to tell us how far you made it in the video. Do it now.